Hello everybody, welcome to another CSGO editing tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use Midji and HLE together. Now Midji is pretty much a modding tool that can be used with CSGO. You can use it to import custom weapon models, use maps and gloves as well, which I'll be showing you in this video. So obviously to begin with, we need to download HLE. So head over to advancedeffects.org and download the latest version of HLE. It'll be in this green box. Just click the link. And I recommend downloading the setup.exe. You just install it like any other program. And once you have that done, we need to actually download Midji. So head over to Zul's Discord server and the download Midji channel. And then down at the bottom, you'll find the latest version. At the time of recording, it's 3.0 beta. So if you're watching this in a few months' time, things might have changed. So just click the link and download the exe. And once you have that done, we need to head to the add-ons channel and we download the gloves removal zip, so just download that. This pretty much fixes an issue that you have in demos where the gloves are slightly messed up and it sets it back to the default ones. And you can change the gloves, so don't worry about that. And if you scroll through here as well, you find a bunch of custom weapon models you can use, plus a bunch of other stuff. So you can just look through and download whichever ones you want. It's pretty much up to you. You can also head over to the Custom Strike Discord server and you'll find a bunch of other weapons as well. So just look for stuff you like and you can import it. You can also download stuff like agents. However, unfortunately with my testing, I couldn't get these to work in demos. If someone is able to get these working or they do work, please let me know in the comments. You can also download stuff such as gloves as well. So if you want some custom gloves to use, so stuff like the Broken Fang stuff, you can download that and we can install it into the game. And for this tutorial, I'm using these custom no scope models. So these are pretty much weapons without the scope on it. So that's what I shall be using. And then you can also download stuff such as custom maps. So these are retextured maps that you can download and use in the game. So if you're looking for that, here you go. I shall be using the one for Mirage. And once you have all that downloaded, I just place it all on my desktop. We need to head over to the CSGO directory. So it's easy for you to do that is just head over to Steam, right click on CSGO, go to properties, go to local files and click browse. And that will bring you to your CSGO directory. So once you have that, all you need to do is drag and drop midji.exe into your CSGO folder. Right click on it, run as administrator, click yes. And just wait for it to create the folder like so. Then we can run Midji. This is what the window should look like. And just click open folder. This will bring you to the add-ons folder like so. Here's the directory that you can see here. Now what we need to do is pretty much just drag and drop the stuff into this folder. So the first thing that we're going to import is the glove removal. So just drag and drop that into this folder like so. And then we're going to install the custom weapons. So I'm just going to use the alt for this tutorial. If you're installing a different model, obviously it'll be a different name. So I'm just going to drag and drop that into the folder like so. And then I'm also going to be installing the custom map. So again, drag and drop that into the folder. And I'll also be installing some gloves as well. So I recommend reading the README file. Gives you a bunch of information. So it tells you which files are what and what gloves. It pretty much tells you what gloves match the files. So I'm just going to pick a random one for the T's. And I don't know, the first one we'll do, I guess. Like so. And yeah, once you have all those in there, head over back to the Midji window and there should be a build button. Just click that, wait for this to finish. And once you have that done, everything has been installed. Now, if you do decide to import some more stuff in, you will have to you'll have to press this button again. So if I install, let's just install one for the CTs. So let's just do this one like so. It will say update builds. You have to just press the button again and it will do its thing again. All right, and that is pretty much done. You can close all that. Now, the namings of the files will matter depending on what you download. If you download a folder, it needs to be p underscore. If you download a VPK file, it needs to be m underscore. So make sure you have those labeled correctly. So once you have all that done, just close the folder, open up HTTP, click yes, go to file, launch CSGO. Your CSGO.exe file, just click browse and then locate your CSGO.exe. It will be in your CSGO directory. Just press open like so. For graphic resolution, you can go ahead and enable this and enter a custom resolution like so. And then for the custom command line options, we need to type in dash game midgy slash CSGO. And once you have that done, just click launch and wait for CSGO to launch. All right, once that's done, you should see this Valve anti-cheat message pop up. That means HLE is working. Just press OK. You can go ahead and press Shift F2 on your keyboard to bring up the demo UI. And then you can go ahead and load up into a demo. All right, and as you can see, he's using the custom weapon model like so, as well as the gloves, and as you can see, we're on this custom map. Unfortunately, there's this like graphical glitch happening with the view model. Not sure what that's really about. So yeah, that is pretty much Midgy. It's pretty easy and simple to use. It's pretty safe to use as well. From what I've read, you can't actually get a VAC ban from it. If you do want to play normally, just close the game and just launch the game from Steam and you shouldn't have any issues. So yeah, hopefully you found this tutorial helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next one.